Well, it's too early to tell. It's the end of one party rule. And so we're back to what we had during most of the Obama years, what we had during most of the Bush years, and what we had during most of the Clinton years, where we had divided government. And so I think you're going to have a different dynamic when it comes to. But I think, Andrew, I think it's too early to tell. I think anything about business is speculation, to raise great fears or to raise great hopes. Let me tell you what I hope. I hope that they can get together on infrastructure. That would help the economy. That would help American business. It would help American workers. That's what I think the common ground
would be. You talked about what divided government has looked like over the past two decades. Mm-hmm. And it has been divided, it has been polarized, and it has only gotten worse, and very little typically gets done. What would be the political incentive, for the Democrats to hold hands with the Republicans over the next 2 years?
What's the incentive for Donald Trump to hold hands with the Democrats? To contangle, but they'd have to find common ground. Right now, there's a wide difference of opinion. And as I travel around the country, that while people want people to work together, they also want their leaders to stand on what they think their principles are. Yesterday was a positive day for America in that we had high voter turnout. What surprised me is that so many races are so close. So that tells me that deep down, we are in this very difficult time in American history, and we can't wish it away, we can't think it away, and it's going to be a lot of work. Common ground is going to be narrow in this Congress. There's going to be, I hope, criminal justice reform, maybe infrastructure, but I don't think that we're going to see a Goldilocks moment in the next 2 years.
Eric, what are the odds of a government shutdown at this point?
Oh, I think we've definitely seen an increase in the odds for a government shutdown. I think President Trump has been very clear. He is not shy about even bringing about a shutdown. And I think he promised before the election that immigration and the wall will be the premise on which that shutdown will likely occur. So we're going to see a lot of focus, I'm sure, when the...
I mean, that's an issue the markets would care a lot about if it becomes a reality. How would you look at the odds at this point?
Well, I would definitely put the odds over 50% that there's going to be a shutdown in December. I think that the president had promised, in the election. He said he would sign the continuing resolution that expires in the beginning of December, right, all over the wall.
So if he's dealing with a budget committee that's not even from his own party.
But he will in the interim. Before December, he'll be dealing with his own party. I mean, this is going to be an interim. Look, Mitch McConnell has been on record multiple times in resisting the idea of a shutdown as a political tool. So there's going to be tension within the Republican caucus about whether a shutdown is going to be held against them. And so I don't think, while the president, I think, is interesting in how he uses leverage, he will talk about a shutdown, he will hold the wall out there. And I think the wall has been his ultimate, if you will, Trump's trump card. And if somehow there's movement on the wall, he loses that as Trump's trump card.
Mark, I want to ask you a question. I'm probably, I'd describe myself as Democrat, moderate, centrist, whatever, I'm in the Bill Clinton mold. But when I look at the Democratic Party today, I see an extreme left part that's saying we're going to impeach this president, first order. You got Jerry Nadler saying that he's going to have judiciary. Maxine is definitely looking for her pound of flesh, vengeance, and financial services. Adam Schiff and Intelligence. And when you've got the liberal wing of the party pushing the Democrats this way, how is the Democratic Party going to find a common ground?
I'll tell you this, Bob. Both the Democratic caucus and the Republican caucus have, if you will, ideological fissures within them. So the Democrats have to find common ground.
What was the lesson of last night for the Democrats, though?
Healthcare works. It worked as an issue. They bet the farm on it, and it got control of the House for them.